GameHub has finally dropped the new 5.3.0 update, and this version pushes the handheld gaming experience to a completely new level. The interface has been redesigned from the ground up with a PS5-style layout, making your Android device feel like a real console the moment you open it. The My Section page now highlights your recently played games at the top for instant one-tap access, giving the whole app a cleaner, faster, and more premium feel. The search experience has been upgraded too, with a refreshed page that shows your history, trending titles, and popular searches all in one place. Discovering new games feels quicker and more natural than ever. GameHub has also added visible playtime stats for recently played titles, letting you instantly see how long you've played and compare your progress with friends. The Steam experience gets a major boost with support for online game updates, an improved sidebar for smooth account management, and a fully revamped library that loads faster and gets you into your games with zero friction. Performance improvements and bug fixes across the board make everything feel sharper and more stable. And the biggest power-up, GameHub now integrates a new DirectX 12-supported driver update with VKD 3D Proton 3.0, delivering noticeably better compatibility and performance in modern titles. Whether you're on MediaTek, Mali, or high-end Snapdragon hardware, especially Snapdragon 8 Elite, this version runs smoother, loads quicker, and feels closer to true PC-level gaming than ever before. So let's set up GameHub 5.3.0 the right way. The first step is to install the official build from the GameHub GitHub page. Open the app, sign in with your Google account, and allow the required permissions because they're essential for proper file access. Once you're in, tap on Import PC Games and add the game's executable file. Since this is a new version of the emulator, it will download the required drivers after you finish the initial setup. In the Settings menu, start with the General section and set the resolution to 960 by 544, which delivers the best balance of clarity and performance for Mali devices. Move down to Compatibility mode and select the latest Proton driver. It might take a moment to install, so let it complete. Then open Translation Terms, where you can choose between Compatibility mode or Performance mode. Compatibility mode supports nearly all titles, while Performance mode works for around 70% of games, so pick what suits your game best. Next, scroll down and set the GPU driver to System, and under DXDK choose 1.11.1 Mali_fix, or 1.10.3 if you prefer. Leave the remaining settings at default, and your MediaTek setup is complete. Make sure you're only playing the games from my recommended MediaTek list so that everything runs smoothly. Now it's time for Snapdragon users. In the General settings, you can select a higher resolution because Snapdragon devices handle increased load much more reliably. Then head to Compatibility mode and choose the latest Proton driver. Under Translation Terms, Snapdragon allows you to run games in Extreme mode or Performance mode. Most titles run flawlessly, but if anything crashes, switch back to Compatibility mode. Also remember to enable multi-thread when using Extreme mode, as it boosts performance significantly. Next, go to GPU drivers. If you're using Snapdragon 8 Elite, select the 80 Gen 5 driver or the System driver. For all regular Snapdragon chips from the 480 and 680 series up to the 8 Gen 3, use the latest Turnip driver. Poco devices also benefit the most from Turnip right now, offering the highest stability and performance, especially on Snapdragon 7 Gen 1 to 7 Gen 3. And even the 8S Gen 1 to 8S Gen 5 range. Just test between System and Turnip to see what your device performs best with. Now open the DXDK settings. If you want maximum performance, use version 2.7.1. If you need broader compatibility, select 2.3.1 or 2.4.1. And finally, for DirectX 12 support, choose the new VKD 3D Proton 3.0 driver, which unlocks DX12 titles with smoother rendering and fewer glitches. Leave the remaining settings on default, and your Snapdragon setup is ready. At this point, your device becomes a true portable gaming machine. Run any PC game, push your hardware, and enjoy the full power of GameHub 5.3.0. And now you can see for yourself just how stable this game is running. The performance speaks for itself. No frame drops, no unexpected stutters, no loading issues, nothing slowing you down. Everything is smooth, responsive, and exactly how a proper PC-level experience should feel on a handheld device. This is the point where you realize just how far GameHub 5.3.0 has come. It's not just launching the game, it's delivering consistent, reliable performance from start to finish, even on scenes where most emulators struggle to keep up. This stability is the real upgrade. The new drivers, the enhanced compatibility, the improved interface, the DX12 support, everything works together to make the gameplay feel natural and effortless. You tap, it responds. You load into a new area, it transitions cleanly without breaking immersion. Even long sessions stay cool and steady, proving that the developers have truly optimized this version for real gaming, not just casual testing. And the best part is that this stability isn't limited to one single device. Whether you're using MediaTek, Mali, or Snapdragon hardware, the results remain solid as long as you follow the setup I showed. This is what a proper handheld gaming experience should look like. So if you've been waiting for that moment when Android finally feels like a true portable console, this is it. Enjoy your games, push the performance, and experience how smooth and stable GameHub has become.